Trips was supposed to be something about the community, cleaning it up and taking care of it. They were very creative, man. I mean, in their dress, in their talk, the language. Could have really been something.
By the time of 72, we knew that it was so many of us, we were shooting each other. So we knew we had to put more order into it because of the criticisms and self-criticisms of what we were doing ourselves.
Crips had a constitution. They wrote kind of like a blueprint, which is kind of identical to the Black Panthers' constitution.
Raymond said, you the one to do that kind of stuff.
Raymond Washington.
Right, so automatically I'm going to come from the Panther Party and say, this is how I go right here. And so we grafted out a definition for the letters. And it was Community Revolutionary Inter-Party Service. This group,
right,
sent a letter of appreciation to the mayor.
And from what I'm told is the mayor's office kind of accepted them kind of shakily, but told them, you know, if we're going to even talk, we got to change this C-R-I-P. We got to change the R.
So they took the R, which was revolution, and they took that definition off and put reform. You had people coming in with programs trying to teach them that basically they should be trying to get into the system instead of change the system. And so they kind of changed the direction of the energy.
Started kind of changing. 70s, the clothes were changing, the individuality, freedom expression.
Beautiful. Proud. I must be respected.
Black Panther Party gone, us organization gone. Both those groups have been neutralized.
Guys who I knew were starch and iron revolutionaries who died for the movement. And I got out, and they was telling me, man, it ain't happening, homeboy.
It ain't about the power to the people no more. It's about power to yourself.
We're out here building a new nation for Black people. It's time for you to start paying some dues, nigga.
I ain't giving you shit.
And I remember the same brothers wearing, you know, trying to emulate the Panthers was like getting ready to afro and laying.
Lord Jesus had dues in the veins and the coast.
But after the Superfly movie, you didn't see no images like Huey.
Yeah, that was gone.
All that was going.
A lot of Black men started saying, well, I'm not going to get involved with that, and I'm not going to get involved with that.
You better take good care of me. Nothing better happen to one hair on my gorgeous head. Can you dig it?
I just started seeing those images on the big screen. You know, it's about me. I'm going to get mine, and they better not fuck with me. I think that was kind of like changing up the guard right around there.
At the end of the movie, won.
When they started making movies like Superfly where guys got away, then, you know, we can do it. And this kept guys like me going to jail.
So what effect do you think at the end of the movie by him winning that they had on the community?
A lot of people out there in Englewood Cemetery, that's the effect it had.
Oh, Superfly.
Back then, even now, you know, brothers want some power, whether it's positive or negative. So if you can identify as I'm a Crip and you gotta watch out for me, then I got your attention. Whether you're crossing the street trying to get away from me, I count. I matter. And it boomeranged on the community and it came right back, you know, and kind of slapped the community in the face because the Crips started measuring who was about the movement and who wasn't about the movement. Who was a Crip and who was a sucker. Who was a brother and who was a house nigga. And they were like judge and jury of who was gonna exist and who wasn't gonna exist.
What is the significance of the leather jacket?
It happened over a leather jacket. I've heard it so many times throughout the community.
It's a status symbol, and most of the kids that have them have paid money, or their parents have paid money for them. And
how extensive is this gang activity to find these jackets?
He said we've been able to clear 40 robberies in the south end of town where jackets were taken.
A war's going on from 1969 to 2003. 2002, 2003 was over a leather jacket? Wait a minute. The whole Robert Ballou killing at the Palladium, they killed a guy for a leather jacket. And he was beaten to death, and then the media just exploded.
Now, you got a generation of people who, you know, they lack in publicity. It was the coverage that the news gave on that situation. And this spotlight is on taking leather coats and whipping ass.
You know, it seemed like it was a conspiracy in the development of all of this. Much of the stuff that was being advertised that Crips were supposed to be doing, they weren't doing. Mm-hmm. But every night, and every day they saw themselves or heard on the news, two Crips shot a white woman on Vine. Two Crips just robbed a grocery store. And it was almost like
promotion.
They made them promotion. That's what it was.
So the media would hype them and say, well, the Crips are like this. Instead of trying to say, we ain't like that, they would, oh, motherfucker, Crippin here, Crippin die.
So you think that's what made it grow so fast?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that was part of it.
Right.
But also there was a void. I mean, there was nothing in the community to join, man.
There were live human beings running around LA, but I was so young, I didn't know them. I would just hear about them and how strong they were. They're almost like these mythical Greek gods. It's Tookie, Jamel, Raymond Washington. Their names are like legendary. I had an opportunity to talk to Jamel, and he explained to me Raymond's concept from the cradle to the grave.
Baby Cribs was really the original name of the Cribs.
I really wasn't with it. He said, look at the baby
Cribs, man. Raymond Washington showed him a baby crib and said that he came up with a concept that was gonna work.
I'm like, looking at this motherfucking crib. This is R.I.P. Cradle to the grave. We're gonna start this gang called a Crib City Bank Bang. He said,
just meant the youth,
right,
of the movement. The older brothers teach the younger brothers, we emulate their example. So our example was revolution.
It was a line in the book that said the Crips and Bloods are the bastard offspring of the political parties of the 60s. The leadership falling apart in the Black Panther Party, the US organization, and most of the gangs were born out of the demise of those parties. You know what I mean? So out of the ashes of the Black Panther Party came, you know, gangs, Crips, Bloods, etc.
You know, we was taught that we want power. Power go to your head. When you learn the power of violence, it can be devastating.
What's happening? I'm writing because shit is still real fucked up in my neighborhood. Pretty much the same way right around the time when you got elected. Ain't nothing changed. All the promises you made before you got elected.
Tell me what the
fuck
these niggas acting up
man,
in the hood.
True.
Send more troops,
dear
Mr. President.
Me and my homies just wonder what's going on.
Acting up in the hood.
Holla.
Why should I lie when I can traumatize? Niggas fell victim to my lyrics, now traumatized. Simply by spitting, I've been blessed, giving riches. Enemies, suspicious, got themselves them in the company of bitches. Bless the concepts I depict. So visual that you can kiss each and every trick of bitch inside the shit I kick. My heaviest burden to move a mountain, casualties in mass amounts. Brothers keep counting for